Crofton Food Pantry, Crofton Council, Crofton.
Thank you. and work, serve, and volunteer for the good of us all. We thank you for all who are gathered here today in your name. Be with us in this time as we give you our thanks and praise for all your goodness to one another. Teach us in this time together to accept one another as you have accepted each one of us by your love and grace. Bless this time together by the power of your Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
A brief word of introduction before our selections from Psalms. In the Hebrew tradition, letters don't just make up words, they also have numerical value. It so happens that the letter that equates to 50 as we celebrate today is the letter Nun that makes the sound of N as in Nancy. It also happens to be that same letter that grammatically becomes both the prefix and the suffix for words that relate to us in the plural in the first person when we choose to say we or us instead of I. There's a message in that alone. Many of the Psalms of our tradition in Hebrew are acrostics and alphabetic acrostics. And in reading through those Psalms, trying to select something appropriate for this day, I was struck by the profundity of each of the messages of those several Psalms that had a Nun verse, and so decided that it would be better than choosing to share several, which requires us to respond in the spirit of the Nun that means we or us. And so there is a phrase from the liturgy. From Psalm 145 as it's taken into the liturgy, and 145 is one of those acrostic psalms, ironically, that leaves out a verse for the letter Nun. And so in the liturgy, we've added this ending refrain that says, let us praise God now and always. Hallelujah. So after each of the selections, as I announced the verse that it was from, I will ask you, in the form of a litany almost, in recitation of the Psalms, to make it inclusive and respond with, let us praise God now and always. Hallelujah. Whoever fears God shall live a happy life. Your children shall inherit the land. 25, verse 13. Let us praise God now and always. Hallelujah. Guard your tongue from evil, your lips from deceitful speech. Psalm 34, verse 14. Let us praise God now and always. Hallelujah. I have been young and am now old, but I have never seen a righteous man or or his children seeking bread. The one who is always generous and blameless, his children are considered blessed. Psalm 37, verse 6. Let us praise God.
We begin with the greeting of peace taught by not only Jesus but Muhammad. Assalamu alaikum. May peace and blessings be upon you all. I'll be reciting a short passage from the Quran that will reveal by Gabriel the archangel upon Muhammad. And then I'll be reciting and reading the translation of those verses.
Ah! Thank you. moved here with his wife, 13, and three young daughters in 1966. He helped found the First Baptist Church in Crofton. He's going to speak to you for a couple of moments, just a couple of minutes. Following him is Greg Coleman, who came and stayed for 23 years immediately before my coming. So Greg is going to talk to you for a couple of minutes, and then Brad, I'm not going to say anymore.
The journey started in 1966. Thank you.
new pharaoh came to the golf community. And we were invited to join just like everybody else. And so, not even to mention these guys, they were such great friends of mine. Pat Ricker had a terrible time. I had some help from some of you to remember his last name. Fred Wood at the Presbyterian Church. Jim Stillwell at the Lutheran Church. Carl Harris at the Episcopal Church. Michael Spillane, right here. We had great fellowship and friendship. And to get our physical together, so we all began playing tennis at the Route 3 Tennis Club. I'm not sure exactly what the name is, but we played there every Thursday afternoon. I don't remember any of the names that some of these preachers gave to the balls as they hit them. It was a great outlet for these ministers, myself included, to fellowship together. And it wasn't all fun and roses. We did meet on a regular basis and share liturgies and spiritual matters. I remember quite well having our friends at this church come to the Baptist church on certain ceremonial holidays and use our building. I think you folks met at the Presbyterian church on Saturday evenings. So if you needed a Wednesday time, some other time you would come to see us. This community has been a great strengthening factor in my life. I remember so many times in our pastoral exchange, which we did once a year, preaching in this fine church, the love, the strength that I drew from this faith community. So really, I've come to thank each of your churches and you for the way you knit together and make the fabric of faith so strong in this community. Thank you so much.
private roads, private water and sewage, no union labor, no government money. Plans for only private schools. He was quoted in the Washington Star in 1963 saying, "I would build a haven where people could avoid the racial turmoil that is about to sweep this country." To buy a home in Crofton, one needed to join the Crofton Community Club. You filled out a form which allegedly was to ascertain whether you could financially afford to live here, but in fact, it was a screening process to ascertain the color of one's skin. People of color need not apply. Model Homes opened in October of 1964. Crofton had a private, uniformed, and armed security force with a guard dog named Mr. Little. The 1,300 acres of Crofton were patrolled by armed security 24/7. If you attended our celebration last night, you were given a key ring, emblematic of the key ring that one needed, this is around my neck, that one needed to show to security to be able to even drive into Crofton. We were private and we were all white. Rowan and Martin's television program, Laughing, was quite popular in those days, but it was said that the family who watches Rowan and Martin Laughing also needs to pray together. But praying together in Crofton was not easy, because the only way to pray in this community was at home. Or if you were a Catholic, you could cross diocesan lines and go to Sacred Heart in Bowie, or to Our Lady of the Fields in Millersville. Slaves of the farm of Crofton had been welcomed by the Jesuits at Sacred Heart. And yes, there were slaves on Crofton farms. Baptists in Crofton worshiped in the home of Reverend Burnis, Barrett, you've heard from, at the corner of Crofton Parkway and Farlow. Baptist children often went to the Sunday school at the Crofton Country Club. Methodists met in what is now the Orff's home at Farrell and Crofton Parkway. Now, the Presbyterians met at Town and Country, what you most likely know as Creative Gardens Nursery School. Episcopalians met at St. Stephen's, a church founded in 1838, a church pretty much committed to the Southern cause in the Civil War. Lutherans attended St. Paul's on 450, and the Crofton Country Club was often home to teas and informational meetings of the Jewish people of Crofton. A geologically and confusing patch of faith communities. Mr. Crawford wanted the private schools of Crofton to be Baptist. The Crofton Elementary site was to be the site of the elementary school, and the now Crofton Woods site was to be the site of the high school. And when disenchanted by residents, some like me, and the county toward his segregated dream, he sold the southern portion of Crofton, which was to be the site of the mega homes of Crofton, to Levitt, and he returned to Louisiana, having donated the site for the Baptist Church at the entrance of Gatehouse, the entrance of the Gatehouse. We now have over 20 faith communities in the immediate Crofton area. Most of them participated joyfully in the planning of this celebration, where we now celebrate our diversity, our inclusiveness, not our exclusiveness. We are not private, we are not all Baptists, we are not all Christians. We are people of faith, Christians, Jews, Muslims. We are conservative, we're liberal, we're certainly not all white. We are diverse, yet we are unified as one in Crofton. We give thanksgiving for how well we have aged to a maturity where we share and applaud our differences and celebrate our openness. The doors of our faith communities are open to all. There are no more private gates, no more key rings that have to let you in. We are many, and yet we are one. Our children now grow up in a town that embraces the love and peace of each other amidst our differences. Today, especially, we know that our much beloved Grandma June, to whom we dedicated the last hymn, is with us She wanted so badly to come here to see you all. She called me Tuesday and asked me if I could read to her the names of the people who would be at the three celebrations this weekend. That was over 700 names. But I said, June, it's going to be okay. They'll all recognize you. And as my co-chair, Debbie Risher, and I planned, we intended to have her rocking chair at the country club for those two nights. Whereas what the words on those rocking, the rocking chair was, but the loving goes on. And for us, the loving grows on. As we continue to grow in our diversity, and in the next 50 years, in the spirit of love and peace. Welcome home.
Sons and daughters of God. In the name of the Father and of the Son us to strengthen our spirits that we might live together wisely. For Lord, you do reveal to us that it is a diversity of people, diversity of gifts, joined in the spirit of the common good that builds and makes healthy community. Though we have never been or shall never be perfect by our own powers, yet we look to you even as we are learning, even as we are stumbling. We thank you for all that is in our heritage. May it make us wiser, make us stronger, and build dreams for our future. We thank you for the religious freedom of this great land and the diverse communities of faith that here in this community represent that great faith and that great freedom. Lord, in your power, we pray and thank you. Amen.
As we look ahead to the next 50 years and beyond in Crofton, we continue our prayers, recognizing that we pray in different ways, but we are one in our commitment to be a community guided by faith and love. As we continue our prayers, I will offer a time of silence scattered throughout the prayer when you are invited to lift up in the words of your choosing in the silence of your heart, in the rhythms of your usual way of praying, your concerns and your joys for our future. Let us pray. We begin by praying for Crofton's future, that our community will not only continue to grow and thrive for the next 50 years, but that we may do so in such a way that we will preserve the best of our heritage, meet the needs of all who live and work here, and be a blessing for those around us. Let us pray. Holy God, you have called people from all walks of life and all corners of the globe to come together here in this community we call home. Bless us so that in the years ahead we will continue to grow and prosper. Strengthen the ties that bind us together so that even as we grow, we will remain attentive to the needs of all and not just some. Guide us so that we will be good stewards of the history and the land, the resources and the opportunities we find here. Lead us into a bright future so that we may become a resource and a blessing for others beyond the boundaries of our city. Let us pray now for Crofton's religious community, that Christians and Jews and Muslims and believers of all kinds may continue to collaborate with each other for the common good and draw on our various traditions for the common purpose of inspiring and equipping Crofton residents to share love and hope and help. Let us pray. Faithful God, although our differences are many, we know that you created us all. Help the religious leaders and their congregations in Crofton to learn how to see each other as cousins rather than competitors. Bind us together through our common desire to serve you faithfully, so that we may promote in Crofton a sense of connectedness and compassion, and work together for the positive transformation of our world. Let us pray for our world. Let us pray for all of the nations and the people of the earth, and for those in authority among them, for presidents and prime ministers, for government representatives, for community leaders, administrators, teachers, clergy, all who may serve. That by God's help they may seek justice and mercy and truth, and live in peace and concord, and through their leadership and their service inspire all to pursue reconciliation and love as our greatest priorities at every level of human society. Thank you.
humbly in your sight we come together, Lord, grant us now the blessing of your presence here. These, our hearts, are yours. We give them to you, Lord. Purify our love to make it like your home. These, our eyes, are yours. We give them to you, Lord. May we always see your world as with your sight. These, our hands, are yours. We give them to you, Lord. Give them strength and skill to do our work for you. These, our feet, are yours. We give them to you, Lord. May we walk along the path of life with you. These, our tongues, are yours. We give them to you, Lord. May we speak your healing words of life and truth. These, our ears, are yours. We give them to you, Lord. Open them to hear your words of guidance. Our whole selves are yours. We give them to you, Lord. Take us now and keep us yours forevermore, as we all respond with one heart and one voice. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
humbly in your sight we come together, Lord. Grant us now the blessing of your presence here. These, our hearts, are yours. We give them to you, Lord. Purify our love to make it like your own. These, our eyes, are yours. We give them to you, Lord. May we always see your world as with your sight. These, our hands, are yours. We give them to you, Lord. Give them strength and skill to do our work for you. These, our feet, are yours. We give them to you, Lord. May we walk along the path of life with you. These, our tongues, are yours. We give them to you, Lord. May we speak your healing words of life and truth. These, our ears, are yours. We give them to you, Lord. Open them to hear your words of guidance. Our whole selves are yours. We give them to you, Lord.